Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the Grosvenor Casino here in Manchester. Grosvenor, our official sponsor for Saturday night's action, and what a night it's set to be. It seems a little bit quieter here than it was in Belfast yesterday. We've had a great 3 days on the Quigg Frampton media tour, and what a time for British boxing. This weekend, there'll be three Brits involved in world title fights in three different countries, and two of those exclusively live on Sky Sports, of course. Anthony Krolov challenging Darlis Perez for the WBA lightweight title, and Martin Murray in Hanover in Germany challenging Arthur Abraham for the WBO super middleweight title. It's a wonderful night of boxing starting from 8 p.m. And as always, I'm delighted to welcome the head of boxing for our exclusive broadcast partner on Sky Sports, Adam Smith.
Thanks, Eddie. Yeah, it's wonderful times. The Quigg Frampton media tour was quite something. Belfast was unbelievable yesterday, and I think February the 27th, that week, is going to be quite something here in Manchester. Really looking forward to this rematch between Darlis Perez to my left and Anthony Krolov. It was a great fight last time, very, very close, and I'm sure we expect the same again on the night. But we'll be kicking off at 8 o'clock with another rematch, Tyrone Nurse and Chris Jenkins, another close affair last time. So I've beaten both boys already, and I'm sure they'll give us plenty of action. Then, you know, we move to Ryan Burnett and Jason Booth. Ryan Burnett, what a fighter he is. I think he's a real star of the future. But Jason Booth, one of my old mates in boxing, I mean, he's been there, seen it, done it. I have so much respect for Jason and where he's come through in his life. I think it's fantastic to have him here still fighting for a British title, and I think he's going to give absolutely everything. Martin Murray over in Germany will be live as he bids to dethrone Arthur Abraham. What a night it will be if he can manage that, and then back to Manchester for Krolov Perez. It's a super one ahead of what will be a super weekend next weekend with Vladimir Klitschko and Tyson Fury in Dusseldorf, and over in Quebec we have James DeGale and Lucien Boutte. Terrific time for boxing, so make sure you tune into Sky Sports, Sky Sports News, SkySports.com for everything in the build-up to this and all of next week.
Thanks, Adam. We'll open it up with a fight which many feel could steal a fight of the night status, and it's a fight for the English featherweight title between Ryan Doyle and Isaac Lowe. Steve Wood, I've got a lot to thank for on this one. Obviously manages both guys, and he knows what a great fight this is. Firstly, Ryan, I know you have huge support. You sold a lot of tickets for Saturday night, and looking forward to a great fight with Isaac Lowe.
Yeah, looking forward to the fight. On paper, I think it's a 50-50 fight. Isaac's a good champion. I mean, he's champion for a reason, and just looking forward to Saturday night.
Obviously, you'll be on late around 10 o'clock. They've expected about 8,000 in there on Saturday night. Be a great atmosphere and a big opportunity for you.
Yeah, most definitely. Great opportunity for myself. You know, to be on such a big stage, I'm grateful for. Just really looking forward to it now.
Thank you. Isaac, obviously a wonderful performance from you in Leeds recently, winning the title from Jamie Spate, and now another big opportunity in front of a big crowd.
Yeah, last time out was a good performance by me. The way I'd done it last time was stopping Jamie in the ninth round, which obviously was a good stage, but now this fight is what can I say, it's a great fight. Ryan comes forward, he looks to come forward and the fight. And so the Live Some Stars make fights, and we're going to give the fans a hell of a fight. I think Ryan's going to be at his best, and I'm going to be at the best, so it's one you've got to watch.
Thank you. The English flyweight title, the first defence of the very talented Charlie Edwards defending his title against Liverpool's Phil Smith. It's another fight we expect to be an absolute cracker. Phil, obviously Charlie's had a quick progression in the pro ranks, looked good, and looking forward to a good fight on Saturday.
Yeah, can't wait. It's my time to shine now as well, so I've got my heart set on that title, so I'm going to put effort into it. Everything that I've seen for and all that for over the years, so I'm looking forward to it.
Have
a good night.
Charlie, obviously had a great camp in Marbella. A good win for you last time out, winning the title from Louis Norman, and now looking forward to your first defence in Manchester.
Yeah, it was a good win the last time in my last outing, but I've put that in the past now. And I've got a tough challenge in Phil Smith. He's going to come and really wants to have a go. It's his World Cup final. He ain't been on the big shows before, so I'm really looking forward to him to put in a big performance, and that's only going to make me perform better.
One fight that's very tough to pick is the first of our British title fights, and the British super lightweight title between Chris Jenkins and Tyrone Nurse. A very, very close fight last time, obviously it was a draw. Many split opinions on who won that fight, and I first ever asked Tyrone, talk to us about that first fight and also your thoughts about Saturday.
You know, we're a good close fight, we're competitive. I said at the press conference last time, I said it might be a fight to steal the show, and you know, I think we did a pretty good job in almost doing that, maybe doing that. You know, it's going to be a good close fight again. Styles are going to gel, but you know, you always say hey, the best man win. I'm sure we all know that the last time, you know, it's the same again this time.
What you look to do differently on the night? You know, I know you felt you won the fight last time. Just same as before, or are you looking to make sure there's no doubts?
That's telling that again. That's it. It's all about styles and tactics. Everyone's got a different game plan for a different fight, and you know, the thing is I can adapt. You know, if we want to fight, we can go to war. That's fine by me. Or I can stand off and I can box you. I can be as lazy or I can work as much as I want. You know, it's up to me what I do, and that will depend on what Chris comes with.
Chris, obviously back at the Manchester Arena. Another opportunity to win that Lonsdale belt. I have to overcome some cuts last time as well in a very close fight. And you look in good shape for Saturday.
Yeah, obviously, you know, I'll cut early on in the fight. And, you know, it's just one of the things, you know. I had 9 months out. There was a lot of things that went into that fight that I done wrong. Being back in the camp, I wasn't really hard. You've been, you know, different gyms like Tony Sims gym. You've been able to expand. Just everything I done wrong in that fight is about putting it right for this fight. And I know that I will win that British title on Saturday evening. So, you know, he can do what he wants. He can run, he can fight, he can use his head, he can do what he wants.
He can win again. I'll win, yeah.
We'll see. It'll be fun.
It's a great fight. That's going to kick off the live broadcast. And a rematch for the vacant British super lightweight title. One fight and one fighter that I'm really excited about on Saturday night is Ryan Burnett against Jason Booth. It's a real classic of youth against experience. Jason Booth, what a story, bidding to become a three-weight British champion on Saturday night. Been an incredible stalwart in the game and still has a huge amount of threat and danger in the fight and hunger as well to become a British champion once more. Firstly, I'm going to ask Adam Booth, Ryan Burnett's trainer, to say a few words about Ryan and also the fight on Saturday.
I think I've said enough about Ryan because I'm confident in what I know and what I think Ryan can achieve. I think, in fact, everyone in British boxing, I've got the utmost respect for Jason for everything that he's achieved, for the type of fighter he is and how he always turns up. And there's nothing in boxing that Jason hasn't seen. It annoys me when people talk about his age. He's seen everything that there is to see in the ring, and he carries that experience. But my belief is, with Ryan, he's going to see everything, but all in one fighter, in one fight. I believe Ryan's special, and I'm really looking forward to his challenge.
Thank you. Jason, I saw a few quotes today, obviously. You know what Ryan Burnett's all about, but you know exactly what to expect. You've seen it all.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of his. Myself, fatal fire. I'm doing exactly what they said. I'm bringing my best. I feel really good. I don't feel old. I feel really young. So I'm just two smoothies coming.
It seems like every time you step up in that fight, where people, I mean, I remember watching you against Lee Haskins, and you put a great performance in there. You know, I know you lost some points, but still, people expected that was one fight too many for you. And it seems that every time you come on this big occasion, you know exactly what to deliver.
Yeah, I love boxing. When I fought Scott Quigg, that was a few years ago then, and I was the old man then, so I don't know what's going on now. But yeah, I'm bringing it.
Good, we look forward to it, mate. Great to have you as always. Ryan, obviously, probably a lot of pressure on your shoulder. A lot of people have been talking about you the last month or so, and the chance now to win a British title on Saturday, around 9 p.m. live on Sky Sports.
Yeah, a lot of people have been building me up, but I think Jason Booth brings a chance for me to show my ability. I don't think as a pro yet I've been able to show what my boxing ability is, and getting in the ring with Jason, I believe that opportunity to be able to show exactly what I'm about will happen.
You feel the pressure for Saturday, obviously, like I said, a lot of people talking about you. This is a level well beyond you, where you've been before, isn't it?
definitely it's a massive step up for me, but you say pressure. I don't feel the pressure one bit, I think. This is meant to be for me, you know, so I don't feel no pressure at all.
Good stuff. That's the second of our two British title fights on the line on Saturday night, and now we're going to talk on the main event. And we're going to ask the champion to speak first and his team, and it gives me great pleasure to welcome back one of our friends, Alex Campanova, and manager for Dalys Perez, and welcome back, and your thoughts on Saturday night.
Thank you, Eddie. Thank you for having us back so quickly. Obviously, we know what happened in the last fight, but this time around, Dalys has prepared not to leave any doubts inside the ring. He's got a great training camp in Colombia, under the watchful eye of Orlando Pineda. He is, at this point, the only Colombian world champion, and he's more than ready to take on Anthony Negron.
Obviously, there was controversy around the first fight, the scoring, also you guys felt there was a, particularly the last point that was deducted wasn't quite fair, but it's kind of like the last fight doesn't matter. It's a clean slate now, and these guys are gonna go and do it again.
Absolutely, I think the styles for both guys are matched perfectly. Should be an exciting event again. And, you know, we're not gonna talk about what happened last time.
Joe, obviously we know how close you are with Anthony Crawler and what it would mean to you. We all felt that we should have been crowned and Anthony should have been crowned world champion last time around, but that doesn't matter anymore, does it? It's all about Saturday night.
Yeah, first of all, big welcome to Dalys Perez and his team and his trainer. Good to see you all again. Saturday night, it's a huge opportunity for Anthony Crawler. I know they've just mentioned there, Perez is Colombia's only world champion. But there's a lot of talk yesterday in Belfast about that being a great fight sitter. Manchester's a great fight sitter. Anthony's got a great opportunity to become the third world champion out this Saturday night. And he's got to go in there and take it with both hands. These opportunities in life don't present themselves that often. And to get a second bite at the cherry, he's got to take it with both hands. It's now or never for Anthony Crawler. Training's gone fantastic. We've studied the first fight and we hurt Perez last time and we will hurt him again Saturday night, and this time we'll finish the job. Very much in the way you've seen Scott Quigg did with Kiko Martinez, also Callum Smith of Rocky Fielding. Anthony, there's no nice guy in there Saturday night. You're going to see a ruthless streak from Anthony Crawler, and we'll be looking for the knockout. And that's what I expect from Saturday night, and to give this great sitter another world champion. And I have 100% faith in Anthony Crawler becoming world champion, and what a fantastic achievement. Okay, here we go again. Ronnie Pickering, come from Belfast. He's come from Colombia here now today again. Come on.
Crawler's the one that's fighting. Let him do the talking.
Joe, you always tend to do this everywhere we go.
Well, to just let you know, I'm booked in at the Opera House for the Christmas pantomime this year as the baddie there, so listen, that's how it goes.
Dalys, obviously there's been a lot of talk about this, the first fight, and tell us how you're feeling ahead of Saturday.
Bueno, buenas tardes para todos. Contento de estar aquí.
Good afternoon to everybody. I'm very happy to be here again in Manchester.
Ya lo que pasó pasó. Tengo una nueva pelea.
What happened happened. This is a brand new fight.
Estoy tranquilo. Vengo bien a 100%. Crawler es un buen peleador.
Crawler is a great fighter. My preparation was really, really good.
Y el día sábado tengo lo seguro que vamos a dar guerra porque vengo preparado sin temor a nada. Y con las ganas de triunfo para dejar claridad.
I am more than ready to give the fans a war, and I know it's going to be a war on Saturday night. My preparation has been terrific, but I'm not going to leave any doubt this time.
What is the difference between this time and last time, and your prediction on how the fight will go from Saturday?
Son diferentes peleas. Son diferentes peleas siempre. Ya lo que pasó pasó. Estamos en el presente.
It's a different fight. It's a totally different fight, and we have to resolve this matter Saturday night.
Anthony, I don't think there's many that won't be cheering you on Saturday night. I'm sure like many of you feel like you should be sitting here as world champion, but that's forgotten, the past, and now you have another chance on Saturday night to become champion of the world.
Yep, that's it. Saturday night, I get a second chance, and not everyone's lucky enough to get a second chance, but
I plan on taking that, grasping that opportunity with both hands. And listen, Dalis Perez, his team, I've got massive respect for. He's a great fighter, and Dalis just mentioned then he's ready for a war, and I see this fight. It was a good fight last time, but I see many more exchanges this time, and I do see it being a bit of a war, and it's a war I'm very confident that I'll come through. And like I say, it's that training's gone fantastic, like George said earlier, and I feel like I've made improvements since that first fight. I'm expecting a better Dalis Perez on Saturday night, but I'm also expecting myself to be better, and I believe that I've gone away, I've worked hard, and those three little tweaks that we've made will be the difference on Saturday night in me becoming world champion.
The difference in your performance this time, do you feel as well physically, tactically and mentally as well? Last time obviously it was a kind of step into the unknown, and now you've been there before.
Yeah, we've shared 12 rounds, me and Dalis Perez, 12 tough rounds. So I suppose you could say this is round 13, and I think we're well matched. But last time out, I felt like we got it right tactically, or Joe did. And I think there was times in the fight where I hurt Dalis, and also that I outboxed him. So I think there's a number of ways I come in the fight. I'm expecting a really tough fight. Like I say, Dalis is a great fighter, but on Saturday, I'm ready to become world champion.
The atmosphere at the Manchester Arena on Saturday will be incredible. Was last time. You've experienced that now. Is it a case of almost, you know, did you feel like that got you last time, in a, maybe in a positive way, but this time it's just another process in the fight?
Of course, I feel like lifted me last time. It was a great reception, and that's one of the people going about the disappointment it was, but that was the highlight of my career, coming out in front of a crowd like that, in front of that arena. And I think Saturday there's going to be a similar atmosphere in there. So I've just got to like say, make sure I'm ready, I've done everything I can do. And this time, I was very grateful for it. I had a lot of support on the back of the incident that happened last year, and it's a bit more business-like this time, which I prefer. We're talking about boxing a lot more, and that's been a great thing in camp for me. So mentally, I'm even in an even better place than I certainly am physically.
Fantastic. That's the WBA Lightweight Championship of the World. Manchester's Anthony Crotter takes on Dalis Perez. It was a great fight last time, it's going to be a great fight again Saturday. I don't think there's many that's not trying to push Anthony Crotter over the line on Saturday. He's a great man, a great fighter, and it's a great fight between two very talented lightweights. So thank you for coming. The weigh-in tomorrow will be at 1 p.m. at the Radisson Blue Edwardian Hotel. Doors will open at 5 p.m. We're going to pose now for head-to-heads with all the fighters and their opponents, and we'll see you at the weigh-in tomorrow. Thank you very much.